Telzio enables you to quickly and easily set up phones in bulk right through your web browser. Most of the configuration process is automated by the VoIP provider, so there's little you need to do to get your IP phones up and running. In this video, I'll walk you through the process of setting up IP phones in 5 easy steps. At Telzio, we help both small and large organizations migrate their landline phones to our VoIP system daily. Setting up the actual VoIP service can be done within minutes, especially if you're using a virtual phone like our web phone or the mobile app. But most of us still prefer having a desk phone. And when you're migrating a team of 100 employees or more over to a new phone system, manually configuring every phone can be tedious, especially if you're programming custom keys. I'll go over how you can create provisioning profiles that automatically configure your phones as they boot up. While there's a slight difference between provisioning Cisco, Grandstream, and Yalink phones, the core principles of auto-provisioning are pretty much the same for all SIP phones out there. What's more, I'll show you how you can actually get the provisioning profiles onto the phones without ever even touching the phones. This saves a ton of time, especially if your users are in different locations. When you provision a phone programmatically, you don't have to click through the phone's web interface and configure each setting manually. Provisioning happens by writing each setting into a text file, formatted in either clear text or something more structured like XML, and then putting that file onto the phone over the internet. This can be done manually by writing the settings and hosting the file on a web server or a TFTP server, or you can use an online platform, which will do all that for you. I'll show you how it's done with Telzio, but the principle is pretty much the same for all VoIP platforms. I'm logged into my Telzio account here, and I'm going to jump over to the Devices tab where you can manage all your devices and configuration settings. You can create groups for your phones and apply universal settings to the phones in that group, for example, time zone and data format, as well as more technical settings like connecting to Telzio over UDP, TCP, or TLS. But let's start from the top and get into the 5 steps of provisioning an IP phone. Step 1, find the MAC address of the phone. Here, I have a brand new Yalink T46S IP phone. It's the model we sell the most of here at Telzio. If you look at the back of the phone, you'll find the MAC address. The MAC address is a unique number that identifies this specific phone. You can find the MAC address for any IP phone on the device itself, whether it's a Yalink, Cisco, Polycom, Grandstream, or any other brand. Step 2, add the VoIP phone to your account. To add the phone to your Telzio account, click on New Device and complete just a few fields here. Give your device a name like Kelly Jensen or Front Desk Phone and enter its MAC address. Select the brand and model of the phone and assign a user to it. For now, I'll leave the group empty and we'll get back to that later. This is the majority of the work that you have to do to get the phone set up. And what's even better is that when you buy a pre-configured phone directly from Telzio, we already have the MAC address of the phone, and so we'll add it to your account even before you receive it. That way, all you have to do is assign a user to the phone and plug it in. Step 3. Customize the phone's settings. Step 3 is optional as the phone will already work with the default settings already in there. But let's take a look at the other settings we can change here. MWI stands for Message Waiting Indicator, and you can enable this so it shows a blinking red light when there's a new voicemail waiting. You can update the codec and SIP transport method you want the phone to use and also change the time zone and time format used on the phone. We're adding new features all the time, so you'll probably see this section expand with more options later on. If there's a setting you want to see here, drop it in a comment below. Step 4, connect the phone to the internet network. Next is the fun part. We're going to connect the phone to the network and see if everything works as expected. Since our network here offers power over Ethernet, we only have to connect an Ethernet cable, and that obviously makes it even easier to manage. Another cool detail is that our network switches are drawing power from a backup battery along with the rest of our network equipment, so if the power goes out, the phones will remain online and our phone calls won't get interrupted. This is a Yalink phone, but the principle of how this is done is the same for the other phone brands. So right now, the phone is connecting to the internet, and because it's a brand new phone that hasn't been configured yet, it's programmed to contact Yalink's configuration servers. Yalink will respond back to the phone with some technical data about how to connect to Telzio's provisioning servers. The phone will then send a new request to Telzio, along with some security credentials that were provided by Yalink to ensure its authenticity. And if all that checks out, Telzio will provide all the settings we made to the phone, and it will be ready for use. Now that the phone is booted up, we can see that our device is online and ready for calling. Step 5, create device groups. Let's get back to grouping devices, because you may want to apply the same settings on all or a group of your phones with the exception of the username. Under Devices, click on New Group and give the group a name. As you can see, we have the same settings here as we do for individual devices. I'm going to go back to the phone I added earlier and assign it to the new group I just created. All I have to do now is to wait until the phone automatically refreshes its configuration, which happens every 20 minutes, or you can give it a quick power cycle and the new settings will register on the phone as soon as it's done rebooting. As I mentioned in the beginning, there are a few differences in phone provisioning for different phone manufacturers. For example, with the Cisco SPA series, you have to enter the phone's IP address and send a provision request, but don't worry, this only takes a few seconds for each device. All in all, automatic provisioning is a feature that saves administrators a lot of time and simplifies the entire process. If you're looking for a specific setup guide, drop a comment to let us know which guide you'd like to see. And if you just want to stay up to date with the latest in VoIP, subscribe to our channel. We have a lot of new content coming your way.